I have tried at least 3 different AI email startups, but none of them were even able to come close to what ChatGPT fine-tuning is able to do for you. Check this out, this is absolutely crazy. You just paste an email that you received as a user message, then hit submit, and it generates an email like exactly in your voice. Nobody would ever be able to tell that this is not me. I spent so much time designing the prompt for GPT-4, but this model is just on a whole nother level. As a small AI development agency owner, currently managing 7 people, emails consume a huge part of my day, and freeing up at least a portion of this time can allow me to focus more on what brings me money and joy. So if you are ready to clone yourself, let's fine-tune your own ChatGPT model right now. To get started with this tutorial, you first have to go to takeout.google.com. Then click deselect all and scroll down all the way until you see mail checkbox. Click on this checkbox and then click on all mail data included, and then make sure that only the sent emails are selected. Click OK and then click next step. Set your destination to Google Drive and click create export. You should get an email when your data export is finished. It can take anywhere from 10 minutes to a few hours, depending on the amount of emails that you have in your mailbox. Now, when your data export is complete, open the notebook in the description and let's start fine-tuning. The first step is to install the packages by simply running the first cell. Then you have to import them and add your OpenAI API key, which you can find at platform.openai.com. Then mount your Google Drive and authenticate with the email that you exported the data for. Find your file in Google Drive and add the file path in the next cell. You can browse files from your Google Drive on the left under the files icon. Next comes a very complex piece of code that I fully don't understand myself, because it was generated with GPT-4. Basically, it extracts emails from your threads and creates a CSV where input text is the email that you have received and output text is your response. If you are curious on how I code like this with GPT-4 almost without any typing, let me know in the comments. Before running the cell, don't forget to also switch your email at the very top. Now, let's go ahead and prepare our data for fine-tuning. ChatGPT expects data in a special JSON-L format, where each line is an array of messages that your model will be fine-tuned on. So, for our scenario, the user message will be the email that you have received, and the assistant message will be your response. Let's clean our data a little bit and remove all the empty rows. Then, we will make a special function that essentially will format our data as I have just described. This function will also add a system message, which you can use to add your own prompt that you usually use to generate emails. Personally, I usually say respond to the following email in a professional, clear, warm, and empathetic style. This will help the model to learn your style faster. Now, let's create a new training data frame using this function and print a few rows. We will do the same for the validation set, which is essential to ensure that our model is performing as expected. This is because testing your model on the same data that you trained it on might give you a false sense of success, because the model will just memorize the answers. We will use 100 examples for training and 100 examples for validation, which is usually more than enough. The next step is to upload our files to OpenAI. After your files are uploaded, you will get special training and validation file IDs. Finally, we can start fine-tuning our model with these file IDs by using one of the newer endpoints called fine-tuning job. You will see your job ID and status after running this cell. Depending on the current demand, it should take anywhere from 10 minutes to an hour to fine-tune your model. However, there also might be a queue if a lot of people are trying to do this at the same time. So, you can check the status of your job by running the next cell or print the events using the cell below. If you see that the loss is decreasing, this means that your model is learning to generate emails in your voice. After your job has finished, you will also get an email from OpenAI with the fine-tuned model ID that you can then use to generate responses. However, a much more convenient way to generate emails is through the playground on platform OpenAI, where you should now be able to select your own model under the Models tab. Let's see how it works. Make sure to add the system message from the notebook that you have defined for fine-tuning. Now, paste a new email that you have just received as a user message and hit submit. I will use another ChatGPT generated email similar to what I often get from potential clients. As you can see, the generated email closely resembles my writing style, and it even includes a link to schedule a meeting, which is what I often do with potential clients. However, some details are not exactly correct. For example, instead of my name, it often confuses the name at the very end. This shows that fine-tuning is not a reliable way to add knowledge to the model, but it is a great way to efficiently transfer the style. You can also add additional details or instructions on how to respond in a system prompt. For example, if I say "decline this request," the model now says that I currently cannot commit to new projects, still in my voice, saving me hours of time. Don't forget to save your fine-tuned model and a prompt as a preset for quick access later. Fine-tuning is one of the best ways to really make your application stand out. So here are some of the best practices from my experience that are essential for deploying fine-tuned models into production. First, you have to make sure that your data is not biased. While it may not be as crucial when generating new emails, if you plan to classify emails, for example, and only train your model on positive ones, it will learn to only predict a positive label. Second, make sure to use a validation set in production. However, keep in mind that validation can be highly subjective when it comes to text generation models. Therefore, make sure to manually review the results as well. And lastly, make sure to retrain your model often. There is a common misconception that you only need to train your model once and its performance will remain the same forever. This is not true. Machine learning systems suffer from data distribution shifts when the data your model encounters in production changes over time and starts to differ from the training data. In other words, as time passes, your users may start asking different questions because the trends might have shifted, for example. In our scenario, the emails that you typically receive may become different over time. Maybe you decided to switch a job or you no longer want to schedule calls with new leads. As a result, your model will no longer be able to provide accurate responses. And if you're looking for a guide on how to create a user interface for your newly fine-tuned model, whatever your use case is, make sure to watch this video next, where I will guide you on how to build an AI-driven web application from scratch. Thank you for watching, and if you want to learn more about how to leverage the power of AI, don't forget to subscribe.